Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate the new JSONata Mapping Node in the ACE version 13 toolkit. JSONata is a lightweight query and transformation language specifically designed for interacting with JSON data. It has built-in operators and functions for manipulating and combining data. You can apply JSONata mapping to fields in the message that is being built. A JSONata mapping node has been added to facilitate generating a JSON message that is sent to a backend, for example, a file, an MQQ, or perhaps as a response message for a REST API. The node conveniently uses the same JSONata mapping wizard that is available in the existing discovery connectors so that it is familiar to use. The JSONata mapping node requires JSON schemas in order to be used. Consider this flow, which uses a GitHub request node to retrieve a specific issue number that is specified in an input message sent to the HTTP input node. The output from the GitHub request node contains a large amount of JSON data. However, the message flow needs to send back a JSON message that contains a reduced set of properties. The JSONata mapping node can be used to choose specific parts of the output to be sent to the next node. There are three steps for configuring the node. A schema needs to be provided for the input data so that mappings can be done. The schema must be added to the map inputs table on the JSONata mapping node. The desired output must be specified by configuring the mappings in the JSONata mapping wizard. The request and response schemas are returned from the discovery connector wizard for the GitHub request node and saved in the toolkit. In this example, a retrieve all action is being done, so only a response schema is returned. When the node is configured using the Discovery Connector wizard, the response schema is stored in the workspace in the same application project as the message flow. The schema can be opened using the Open Response Schema button on the Basic tab. The response schema can be used for the JSONata mapping. Schemas must be added to the Map Inputs table in order for them to be used by the JSONata mapping node. When you click on Add, the schema of a previous node is automatically added to the Map Inputs table. After adding the schema to the Map Inputs table, the fields in the schema can be used for mapping. As a result, specific fields can be selected so that a trimmed-down JSON message can be returned by the message flow. So let's show how to use the JSONata mapping node. I have a flow here which is using the GitHub request node, and I've already configured it. If I launch the Discovery Connector wizard, you can see that it is returning the issue from GitHub by using the issue number that is specified in an input message. If I try running the flow through the flow exerciser and send in a GitHub issue number and click send, I can see that the response contains a large amount of JSON data which describes the issue which is in GitHub. So I want to return a trimmed down JSON message which contains specific JSON properties. So I can do this by using a JSONata mapping node. The JSONata mapping node is in the transformation drawer, and if I add it into the flow after the GitHub request node, I can configure it. So the GitHub request node already has a response schema, and you can open the response schema by clicking the Open Response Schema button in the Basic tab, and here is the schema. It is in the same application as the message flow. And on the JSONata mapping node, if I select the map inputs table, I can click on add, and it will find the schema from the previous node. So I can just click OK here, and the schema is added to the map inputs table. If I now open the JSONata Mapping Wizard, I can specify which properties I want to map. So I can specify title, description, and number. And then I can click on Edit Mappings and specify where those fields are located in the input message. They will be taken from the response from the GitHub request node. So I can select title, I can select description, and I can select issue number. So if I save this and close the wizard, I'll save the message flow. If I now redeploy the flow and put a message into the flow using the flow exerciser and click send, I can see that the JSON message that is returned contains fewer properties than before. So I have been able to do this by using the JSONata Mapping Node. If I click on the wire after the JSONata Mapping Node, I can see the message tree that is coming out of the JSONata Mapping Node. So in this video, I've shown how to use the new JSONata Mapping Node in the ACE version 13 toolkit. There are three steps for configuring the node. A schema needs to be provided for the input data so that mappings can be done. The schema must be added to the map inputs table on the JSONata Mapping Node. The desired output must be specified by configuring the mappings in the JSONata Mapping Wizard.